In this video, I'm going to be drawing this painting from Modigliani. It is just going to be a pencil drawing, and I am going to also have a little conversation with you, especially if you're feeling frustrated. So, I hope you enjoy it. Welcome to the I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you are art inclined and love acrylic painting tutorials, this is your channel. This painting from Modigliani is called Two Girls, but I'm going to make a couple of changes for my personal taste. Number one, I am going to change the eyes of the girl. And number two, even when it is called Two Girls, for me, it's going to be mother and daughter. And after this video, I'm going to be painting it in a separate video. So, based on this that I want you to see close, what I'm going to be doing is changing the eyes, because although it was fine to be in a museum like this and it's totally Modigliani style, I personally would like to see it a little more kind of angling the right way. I am just going to go eyeballing it, and I'm going to use this pencil because I make a lot of mistakes. And when I think, where is it? Well, I don't even know where it is right now. And this typically is something I would have deleted from the video, but I want you to see that we are not perfect. We make a lot of mistakes. Here's the pencil I was looking for. So, I was looking at this post from somebody, a beginning artist, that was very frustrated because she couldn't keep up with a challenge and keep up with a tutorial. And she was just about to give up painting altogether. And I think we should not compare our beginning to somebody else's middle of the story, to somebody that has been, you know, bunch of years into creating. What we have to do is compare each of our drawings, each of our paintings to ourselves. Make sure that we're improving a little bit at a time. Art is not perfect. Art is completely personal. If you want to, for example, me right now, if you want to recreate somebody's art, what you can do is practice a ton, drawing a lot, and if you have to start by drawing circles and ovals and squares, that's fine. That is completely fine and acceptable, because it doesn't matter that somebody had a gift of drawing faster than you. You need your own personal speed, and also enjoy the time. If there's a lot of ugly pages in your art journal, or if you mess up in your canvas, I want you to go check it out slowly and embrace it. Why? Because when we embrace that creation of ours, we are giving ourselves permission to move to the next step. There's no speed, there's no metal gold at the end when you finish a challenge or a painting. There's just the satisfaction that you finish that one and you go to the next one, and the next one will be better. And sometimes the next one will be worse, but there's also a little learning in each experience. Probably I can make a video on all the messes I have made. I have papers where I overprinted when I'm doing the jelly printing. I end up with this catastrophe all in one muddy color. I don't put it on the video because what I want is to show you something well finished, if I want to show you the best way to do it. But if I was to show you all the crappy ones, you will be surprised. And when you're drawing, you can erase. When you're painting, you can paint over. When you're jelly printing, you can make another pass of paint. Beauty is just a couple of layers away, especially with acrylic paint, because you can just, you know, go over. In all the other mediums, you can't, but there's always another page, another canvas. So if you're feeling frustrated, I would like for you to take a deep breath and just enjoy the moment. There's enjoyment even if in the messiest of all art problems. Paint because it's Friday. Paint because you love purple and yellow. Of course you want to paint to learn, but don't feel so frustrated with your drawing or with your painting that you will stop. So that's the message that I wanted to tell you today. If you want to see how this drawing turned into a painting, check the next video. It's going to be fun. And remember to keep your pencil sharp and your paintbrush wet.